So I'm speaking to you at a good time, I think. You're coming in just about on almost 2 years of heading up Canada's pension plan organization. And I know you'd said early on when you joined that one of the things you noticed coming to Canada from Asia was that Canadians didn't really have a full understanding of what their pension plan was all about. Can you talk a bit about that perception and what's transpired since?
Yeah, sure. It was a huge surprise to me that around the world, CPPIB is really known as a leading investor of our type in whether it's in Asia now or in Europe or in North America. And so it's very broadly well known within the financial industry. And when I came to Canada, I presumed that CPPIB would be really well known in Canada. And it certainly is within the financial industry. But when you get out to the rest of the country, people, unprompted, really don't know who CPPIB is. In fact, about 3% of Canadians know who CPPIB is, which was very surprising. Most importantly, though, they don't understand the strength of the Canada pension plan system and the fact that it's sustainable, and the fact that it's measured by the chief actuary, the office of the chief actuary, every 3 years, who says over a 75-year period, this is a sustainable plan. And he comes in every 3 years and reconfirms that. Most people in the country, in fact, two-thirds of Canadians think that the plan may not or will not be there for them when they retire. And that's a huge disconnect versus the reality of the fact that it will be there and it's independently tested by that office of the chief actuary.
Why do you think that is? Why do you think people are assuming that it won't be there for them?
You know, I think it goes back to two things. I think one was the huge shock that happened in the 1990s when the plan really wasn't sustainable. And the chief actuary published a report saying, if you continue on like this, he published a report in 1996, he said, if you carry on like this with the same benefits that you've been paying in the sort of 70s and 80s and 90s, and the same contribution rates that people are paying, then there'll be no money left in the fund by 2015. And I think that caused a huge shock in the country. It resulted in a couple of things. It resulted in the plan being restructured, so it was put on a really, really sound footing. And it resulted in us being formed as CPPIB, an independent arm's length entity, to invest the money globally. So the crisis happened in the 1990s, but I think somehow that sort of reverberates down the decades. I think the second thing is that people read the headlines about the troubles in the US system or the systems around the rest of the world, and they presume that there must be the same problem here. Fact is, you know, Canada had its crisis in the 90s and it made really, really smart decisions and put the plan on a really sound footing. So people can, you know, can be sure that the plan is on a sustainable basis right now.
Now, is it important that people know that? Are you putting any efforts into telling them, or does it matter one way or the other? You can manage the money without people understanding. You just feel like a broken record always saying it's sustainable.
Yeah, so we thought about it, and I think there's, first of all, I think it's important people know, because if they don't know, a lot of people are sort of paralyzed into not doing much for their retirement. The number of people who think they're going to need to rely on the plan, it keeps tracking up. So we've done this survey for about 15 years, and it's tracked up year after year after year. So about almost half the population in Canada, 47% of people, say they're going to need to rely on the plan. And so there's a horrible disconnect when two-thirds of people don't think they can rely on it, and only half of people think they need to rely on it. So if you think you need to rely on it and you don't think it's going to be there, then people can get sort of paralyzed into fear and not save. If you know it's going to be there, you can have the confidence in that, then you can have confidence to save on top of that. Second, from our point of view, our job was not really to explain the plan to people. Our job is purely to invest the money. But we decided that, you know, we should probably step up the effort to so people do really understand. While it's not a technical responsibility of ours, I think it's important that people understand, because then they understand what we're doing and, you know, why we're doing it for them. And then, you know, through good times and bad times, they'll have a better understanding of the work that's been done here for them. You know, we've had a really good year this last year. We're up 11.6%. We've had a really good run over 5 years. We're up 12.1%. 10 years, up 8%. But, you know, we know statistically, 1 year in 10, we're going to be down at least 12.5%. And so that's going to happen. You know, it may happen this year, it may happen next year. but it's going to happen statistically. And I don't want that to be the first time that people say, oh, what's this entity, CPPIB? What are they doing? They should understand we're doing, you know, we're working really hard. We're taking, you know, really responsible risk to grow the pool of money that supports their pensions. And the pension system is really sustainable over the long term. And so they understand all that context. So when they see it down there, they go, oh, yeah, okay, well, we understand that. That's in the context of you know, everything else.
Right, and
so not to worry about it. I don't want people to be alarmed or worried just because they see one down year or something, because that'll happen.
You're thinking in terms of sustainability over 75 years.
Yeah.
And it doesn't just mean people at the end of the 75 years get the money or else, sorry, at the tail end. It's sustainable means they're getting it all the way along. Right?
Yeah, exactly.